In this lecture, we are just going to see the working of LCDs. The 7-segment display can only display numbers, but for displaying characters and alphabets, we cannot use this 7-segment, as this LED arrangement cannot fulfill this purpose. So for this purpose, we are going to use LCD displays. They are available in many variants, but display which we are going to use is 16x2 LCD display. As the name says, there are 16 columns and 2 rows in this display. Each display element can display one character or number, so totally we can display 32 characters at a time in this display, as we have 16 columns and 2 rows. Now let us understand how this display element displays numbers or characters. This display elements are nothing but a 5x8 dot matrix display, which again has 5 columns and 8 rows. Let's say if I want to print the character R in this display, I can make the corresponding bits of the dot matrix display to be high for doing this purpose. Similarly, you can display any numbers or characters using this dot matrix display. Ouch, this seems to be very complex, right? Don't worry. We need not turn on and off each and every bit of dot matrix, as every LCD display is coming along with a controller for doing this purpose. Most commonly used controller is HD44780 from Hitachi. And now this controller has two registers. One is instruction register and another one is data register. We just need to do two things. Pass the address at which we are going to print in the instruction register. Pass the data that we are going to print in the data register. Then the character gets printed. Address of display elements in LCD starts from 0x80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87. 88, 89, 8A, 8B, 8C, 8D, 8E, 8F. Second row starts from 0x C0, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9, CA, CB, CC, CD, CE, and CF. You can either pass a 8-bit data or 4-bit data to this LCD. Here are some of the commands of LCD, note it down for future reference. Pinouts of LCD are: first pin is VSS, which is the ground pin. Second pin is the VDD, which is 5V. Third pin is VEE, which is used for varying the contrast of display elements. Fourth pin is RS, that is register select, which is used for passing data to either instruction register or data register. If it is 0, data will be passed to data register. If it is 1, data will be passed to instruction register. And the fifth pin is RW, which is read or write bit, which is used for selecting whether we are just going to read from the LCD or we are going to write to the LCD. If RW is equal to 0, write operation is performed in the LCD, and if RW equal to 1, read operation is performed. And the next pin is enable pin, which is the clock enable pin of the LCD. Either for reading or writing, we just want to enable this bit. And next 8 bits are D0 to D7, which are the data lines of the LCD, through which we will pass the data to the LCD. And the next pin is anode of the backlight of LCD, and next one is cathode of the backlight of LCD. And this is the circuit for interfacing this LCD to a microcontroller. At first, we just need to define the length of data, either 8-bit or 4-bit, and then we will pass the address at which we are printing to the instruction register, and then we will pass the data to the data register, and the character gets printed. In the next lecture, we will interface this LCD to a microcontroller. Thanks for watching.